Hi, Vasilis, and it's so good to talk to you again. It's good seeing you again. And just for the audience, could you just give a short introduction of yourself, please?
Yeah, my name is Vasilis Pachundakis. So I'm the legal representative and the field coordinator of SMH. SMH is a medical and rescue team from the Basque Country, from Spain. We are in HEOS from 2015. For the first months of the refugee crisis. And until the 2015, until now, the last 5 years, we are still in HEOS. HEOS is an island of the North Aegean Sea, but in HEOS, we have almost 500,000 of refugees. These months, we have only one boat per month. But after July of 2015, we have almost between 16 with 24 boats per day.
What is the setup on Chios itself? So there is a camp on Chios. It's called Vial. So how many people are living there? Are there refugees anywhere else on the island? Are they all living in the camp? And what is the situation like in the camp?
It's 8 kilometers outside of Chios. The capacity of the camp is between 1,000 to 1,294 people. And now we have, let's say, 6,000 people.
So what is the situation like for the ones living in the camp, in the official camp, the former official camp, and in the area around it?
About the food. The food is totally crap. It's not eaten. I have a friend that he's a cleaner inside the camp, and he told me, Vasilis, you know, even my pigs, they didn't eat this food. It's not eatable. So the people, they try to find other solutions to take some food from the supermarkets in Chios. They cook inside the tents. For that reason, we have a problem with the fires. The water right now is connected with a system of the water company in Chios. They changed some plumbs and they stopped to bring water to the Vial. So the people, they didn't have water even for washing their hands. They didn't have drinkable water. They didn't have opportunity to approach even to both of this type of water. So just one question, Vasily.
Yeah. What you described with the electricity and that there are taps, even though they have not been running, this would only be in the official camp, wouldn't it? It's not in the surrounding area for all the ones living in tents. As far as I know, there is nothing there. There's no electricity.
Yes,
there's
exactly.
No taps, no running water. Is that true?
Exactly. They didn't have a shower. They didn't have a toilet. So you can see the people around the fields make their own, you know, their pee, their poo outside, even in the snow, it's not awkward. It's awkward for the European civilization.
So how have things changed since all these corona measures are in place, the so-called lockdown, quarantine, or whatever I call that? How have things changed for the people living in Vial camp?
The people stay inside the camp. They can't move, they can't travel. The taxi drivers that the previous time took the people from the camp to the town, or the buses, they are stopped immediately one day. So the people, if they want to move to town, they must to walk 8 kilometers and 8 kilometers back. They allowed one member of each family every 10 days. So the people are stuck inside the camp. So it increased the tension inside the camp because the people, when they have the opportunity to leave, the tension is rare.
So what would the differences be like in treating or prevention measures for local people and for the refugee people?
Until now, before the coronavirus, of course, the refugees, they have the same treatment with the locals. We provide the medicines because the hospital didn't provide the medicines. And if you don't have money to buy for the pharmacy, of course, the people, they didn't have insurance numbers. If you don't have insurance numbers, you can have an access to the pharmacy to buy your medicine by free. So the people, they need to buy their medicine. The same happened. If we are not here as SMHs to provide all the medicines, the people that are dying.
The medical treatment, the medical service for the people inside the camp, realistically spoken, is not provided by the state right now. It's not provided by the authorities right now, but it's basically provided by an independent NGO, SMH use. in cooperation with the German group, Wir packen es an. You said you have enough equipment now to treat the people.
Of course.
So this is something people in Germany have been able to do to support your work. Is that correct?
Until now, Wir packen es an, they provide us the last months almost the 99% of the materials and equipment that we need to the island. And that everything happened very fast. That's the most important.
In Germany, there is this kind of movement, this campaign, and they call for evacuation of the camps, the refugee camps on the Greek island. What do you say about that?
Yeah.
Thanks a million, Vasilis. Thank you so much.